What can we actually say about the rate of contagion and the lethality of COVID-19 at this point? Is it as bad as the WHO originally said, 3.4% death rate? Can we say that with any firmness? Are we sure the death rate is worse than that of the seasonal flu, et cetera? Can you just talk about what we can actually know about it?
So this is a major debate, and data are evolving on an hourly basis. So I will tell you what we know as of now, but it may change very quickly. The WHO indeed released an estimate of a case fatality rate of 3.4%, which at the time of the release earlier in March, it was based on the number of people who had died as the nominator and the number of people who had documented infections as the denominator. This is a crude estimate, and it largely depends on our ability to capture infections that are in the denominator. The number of deaths hopefully is captured with more accuracy, even though even for that number there can be some debate, for example, whether these deaths are by SARS-CoV-2 or with SARS-CoV-2, or also whether some deaths are missed or whether some people who are infected now may die later and we have not captured these deaths yet. But the bigger uncertainty is about the denominator, because based on what we know now, many people who are infected with this coronavirus, they present with very little, either no symptoms or mild, moderate symptoms that are very difficult to distinguish from the common cold and common flu. And many of them apparently would not present for asking for health care and for being tested. So what we know is just the tip of the iceberg. And information from settings where we have more complete information about that denominator suggests that the infection fatality rate is much, much lower than 3.4%. It is actually probably much lower compared to the 0.9% that is the main figure that went into some influential calculations by a wonderful team of researchers in Imperial College, which probably overestimated the exact infection fatality risk.